you.
Good morning, everybody. First of all, happy anniversary to everybody, and thank you, Angela, thank you, dear friends, for this invitation. I'm really happy to be here to celebrate with you by this special event and to discuss today one social biological phenomena about the synergy but human with microbes in post-truth era. So, after so nice presentation at the molecular mechanism and the genetics, epigenetics, I think it's not will be difficult for you to go and to meet now the good and the bad bacteria, to recognize what is the human microbiome, gut microbiome, and to help me to answer, are you only Homo sapiens or also we are in the fortune of microbes too? I invite you to become now microbiologists at little for 10 minutes during my presentation. After molecular biologists, nanobiotechnologists, welcome in the field of the microbiology. Everybody know human evolution. Everybody know that we are originated from the primates, from the mammals. But everybody forgot for the bacteria. At the beginning have been microbes. More than 500 million years, animals have the inheritance of the microbiota. The same microbiota we carry out also. And we are living with cooperative interaction between microbes and their host typically involve microbial participation in the host function, such as defense, metabolism, and reproduction. So everybody carry out one so-called human microbiome. We are not alone. We carry out 100 trillion good bacteria in our human body versus 10 trillion cells for every body. Don't worry that microbes overcome 10 to 1 our cells in the body, because these microbes, which are organized in so-called human microbiome, this is all microbes which are living in our body, they carry out also the genes. Dr. Dimitrova very well presented to Dr. Leseva what are doing the genes, and pay attention, 37% from our human genome is originated from our cohabitants, the bacteria. We are probably only 10% human. Let's go discuss this. Everybody create our own microbiome. 90-10% from us is our individual human microbiome. Even twins has difference, even twins from one germ have the different individual microbiome. But most important is that this microbiome has some vary by anatomical site. On this slide, I presented some data concerning, you can see how many microbes carry out in our oral cavity, in our skin, small intestine, but the major part, the oasis for microbes, it's a large intestine, it's a colon. You have several good bacteria, I pointed, well-presented lactic acid bacteria and bifidobacteria, which are our helper for the health. All these microbes, cited, organized, from the human a super organized. Dr. Dimitrova well explained the environmental factors and told that we are environment and genes. Today I would like to tell you, we are not only environmental and genes, we are also environment, genes, and microbes. And also the nutrition, in presentation just finished, you will see what is important, the diet, and all these microorganisms with 3 million genes, with this synergy and symbiotic way to function, determine healthy status of everybody, from health to diseases or translation position. Let's to see who are these bacteria. They are organized like the society in three groups. First, the major, the amazing one are the good bacteria. From other pole, they are the bad bacteria responsible for the illness. But like in the human society, there is a large or small group, it depends of the individuals, with This doubtful bacteria occasionally pathogenic. They could be passed here to be good bacteria. They could be passed here. It depends from the relationship with the host. The good bacteria always are in symbiosis. They are living in our gastrointestinal tract and they are in good synergy. When you have the dysbiosis or become to the problem of intestinal or other characters. Who in our microbiome? Isn't it that bacteria are different role? I can tell you that all these bacteria, these trillions of bacteria, determine the direction between the illness and health. Do you know, help me, do you know which is the most distributed illness and in the same time very expensive to treat? Some proposal? Please, don't hesitate.
A cold.
No. Other, please. Sorry? No, caries. Caries is the most distributed illness. I was also surprised. And very expensive because everybody on the planet several times during their life suffer from this. And take attention, oral microbiome. The microbiota in your oral cavity often is responsible for the health of your dentist. And also, even now, they work on the natural way to protect oral cavity. Also, why I put here the pregnant lady? Because even during the neonatal period, the microbes influence programming of the fetus and also programming the healthy status for all life of the newborn. Several ladies are here. Do you know what is the more protective microbe in vagina? Again, lactic acid bacteria. And if you suffer of disturbance of lactic microbiota in the vagina, you are in high risk in bacterial vaginosis, which touch 30% from woman population, from sexually transmitted disease, yeast infection with several recurrence. So the microbes, the good bacteria, but the most important, again, is a gut microbiome with several presenters inside, but responsible, be careful, for so dangerous non-communicable diseases, cardiovascular, obesity, metabolic syndrome, cancer, etc. So here we have more attention about our health. Therefore, the gut microbiome today was decided that is one very important functional organ. Everybody pay attention about the liver. You do the observation, triglycerides, cholesterol. How many people here, even any time during the life, pay attention about the parameters of gut gastrointestinal microbiota? Could you show me? If somebody, Angela, greetings. Ada, one, and you are so now, even me. So today, not only the microbiologists, but also the doctors pay more attention about the homeostasis of gut microbiota. Why? Because here we have to do always to have a healthy balance. And it could be reached by probiotics. What are probiotics? In 2002 and 2014, special committee confirmed the definition. This is the leaf microorganism, which when administered in adequate amount, can cover healthy benefits for your health. So, briefly, really simply, this is the leaf microorganism that ultimately improved the balance of the intestinal flora, thus fostering healthy gut functions through a healthy gut microbiome. The probiotics are good bacteria that help our health through the gut homeostasis. This small picture illustrates in our intestine, they influence through the gut barrier, nutrient with our digestion, also immunity, defense against infections, but be careful, signaling to the brain. So at all aspects, good microbiota could be a guarantee for your health and diseases. This is some good helper for a healthy balance in all organ system. They promote this necessary symbiosis in human microbiome and especially in the gut microbiome. If you don't pay attention, you become in the yellow zone, the dysbiosis, which is invisible for everybody usually. But in the red one, in the red zone, intestinal problems started, and together with several disorders. This nice picture from one recent publication clearly show the relation with disbalance, dysbiosis in the gut microbiota with several illness. It is not only the pain in the gastrointestinal, it's not only the bloating. This is only the symptoms, but also such important diseases like metabolic diseases, liver diseases, and the diseases of central nervous system. You can mention here autism. Autism is, the statistic is very stressing. Now there is a big discussion. I hearing data that in 2050, every five child will be suffer from autism, probably in the developed country. Can you imagine? And what we, what microbiology determined, the autistic kids have very poor gastrointestinal microbiota. There is no richness of species and the number of bacteria presented in the gut. So probably this theory is very important to be developed here. Because how is function? The probiotics help the intestinal microbiome homeostasis, nutrition too, and they directly influence at first level the metabolism with food digestion, nutrition absorption, detoxification, important synthesis of several enzymes which support the digestive processes, the other processes, and vitamins. Also the immune system. Do you know that 70-80% from immunocompetent cells are disposed in our gut? So 70-80% of our immune response start from our gut. It's necessary to keep the homeostasis, reduce inflammation, contribute to healthy immune repertoire. But very important also, they prevent to spread of diseases from various organisms like parasites, bacteria, viruses, and fungi. And be careful, manufacture neurotransmitters. Let's to take a little look again on the obesity. You know already the mechanism, how it's happened, probably due to the malnutrition of parents, but even the twins, this is the clinical study in the Turku University Central Hospital, Department of Pediatrics in Finland, two twins, one obese, other lean, they have different level of probiotic bifidobacteria in the gastrointestinal tract. When the level is higher or normal, there is a normal weight, no body mass index, and contrary when the bifidobacteria are very reduced. The in vivo experiment, murine model with germ-free mice and microbiota transplant from obese twin and from lean twin, even low-fat, high-fiber diet, you have the same results. Because the microbiota introduced here in the free of microbiota mice function and contribute to this problem. Probably due to some kind of signals, probably from other mechanism. But I would like just to show you other very interesting phenomena. This is the influence of microbe through the gut brain axis. Do you know where is secreted the hormone of happiness? Sorry, where is the place that your body produces serotonin? Brain? No, gut. 80% of serotonin is produced. Even the doctor, I asked the doctors, and they told me in brain, no. 80% of the serotonin is produced in your gut. So, also, pay attention. Your good microbiota is responsible for amino acid production from the proteins in your gastrointestinal, destroyed proteins, catabolized proteins, and they are the precursors, essential vital neurotransmitters. And let's to see how it's function, this gut-brain axis. It's a very important, it's the same axis that is probably influence the cases of autism. It's a now very, very interesting phenomenon, and several laboratories work on this. I will be happy to work together also, but maybe in the future. So, there is a clinically proven effects on brain areas receiving signals responsible for the control of emotion and sensation. This is clinically proven. But also, I presented small experiments, again, Murin model, with two groups of mice. Mice which was with experimentally induced colitis. And researchers, scientists, observed very stressed behavior. The mice with induced chemically induced colitis in the gut was stressed, were with anxiety, and they don't eat. They was absolutely stressed. They decided to treat with the Bifidobacterium longum, is one of famous probiotics bacteria. Only 50 days, daily dose 1 billion, and surprisingly, they normalize the behavior. They become, despite of the colitis, they become happy. After that, they decided to discover what is the mechanism of this effect. They destroy the nervus vagus. It's the central nerves which is responsible for the signals from to our body. They do the vagotomy, and the effect of Bifidobacterium disappear. It means that good gut bacteria produced neurotransmitters which become in the brain and correlate with the behavior and emotion. But not only alive, but they could be very useful for your health. Even destroyed, because during the passage in our gastrointestinal, several probiotic bacteria are destroyed, even destroyed, they could be helpful. How? A component of the cell wall of lactic acid bacteria, muramyl peptide, are proven to be capable to induce of endogenic production of morphine, hypnotic effects, regulation of glucose metabolism, anti-inflammatory, liver protection, detoxification, immune modulation, radio protection, anti-tumor effects, septic shock therapy, anti-allergic, vasodilating effect, thermoregulation in analgesic effects. So, even 400 years before Christ, very famous philosopher Hippocrates taught, health is determined by the microbiota in our gut. So, be healthy, think about the nutrition, think about good health in your gut, a goal with your gut, your second brain. And now you have to answer, are you so only human sapiens or microbes make men? You are. Thank you very much.